Companies are scared, far worse than the 2008 disaster, as a computer algorithm, I'll show you, it compiles everything, and it's like, this isn't looking too good, and Uber and Lyft mass layoffs, it looks like we went from the shared economy to no one is sharing. And I have a feeling that this earnings call, just like all the other ones that have been going on for Lyft, will not be looking too good. Probably as of filming this video, it's happening right now, and New York is set to lose almost 1 million jobs because of this lockdown. But now that Lyft has basically fired everyone, sarcasm, it's not everyone, all you sneaky traders out there, you got all your put options, you got all your options ready for this earnings call to take your profit. So we'll head on over, take a look at Lyft's stock. I'll give you some technicals on it and a few more stories that basically says that the game is over for the United States economy, the real economy, not the financial economy that they're getting ready. They're lathering all their sunscreen, oil, getting ready for summer. Thank you so much, Powell. What a great guy. Always bailing out people that really need the help, right? You know, not you or... Welcome back to my channel where I teach you about the real economy versus the financial economy. Like, the real economy is getting wiped out, but that does not mean that you can't make money in this scheme. You pull back the curtains, you look around, you're like, oh, okay, I see what they're doing, I'm gonna do that, and oh, okay, so the Fed's doing that, I'm gonna do that. So if you like YouTube videos and dudes with funky hair teaching you, helping you how to make money, will you at least consider subscribing to my channel? I'll get back to this in just a second. Lyft, $26.09 earnings call coming up. Hold your breath, but hundreds of earnings calls in 2008 were okay compared to what we are dealing with right now. A computer takes all of, you know, all the things, the jargon that is spoken, and they are saying that they are now more scared right now than they were in 2008. But that's okay. Jerome will just step right on in and backstop just about everything because we don't want that little tail swinging down there. You got to put a little floor under that so everyone at the top 1% gets to keep all of their beachfront properties. But it says this once in a century, cannot use the word, has unleashed financing fears all over corporate America that far exceeds the 2008 crisis as executives prep for fresh economic and market pain, which I wouldn't say they've experienced the pain just yet. I mean, if you guys have been invested in the FANG stocks and just stayed in there, that thing was kind of like just a fart in the wind. You're like, ah, did you smell that? No, no. Jerome, you smell that? No, didn't smell anything. And if you've been on this channel long enough, you know if I can make you laugh one time, all that I ask is that you push that little button down there. It helps out the YouTube stuff. In other words, that I cannot say. But some of you jump, you know, in the comment section, they're like, oh, you're disgusting. You're a pig. I can't stand you. Dislike. I'm going to throw car doors at your face if I ever see you. Some 42% of American non-financial public companies are discussing slashing investments. Now, this is what the algorithms are. Oh, I said that word. Shoot. 27% are talking about equity payouts and 17% are focused on drawing down on credit lines. Conclude economist Andrew Y. Chen, at the peak of the last recession. So let's look at this. It was 25% compared to 42% and 11% compared to 27% and now 7%. And if you guys are better at pictures than you are at charts, I drew you a nice picture of how the market is feeling about this. This is your regular run-of-the-mill CEO of most companies that are not part of the FANG stock. And another story coming out of Bloomberg is buy when the Fed is buying won't work anymore. And the key word I want to focus my attention is anymore. Well, It's a working now, so we will just keep going with what is working, and I will change my tune later when it no longer works. The recent rebound in stocks was built on false hopes about the economy and efforts to stem bad word. And I'd have to say, not much of an economy when within 2 weeks it gets completely wiped out, and you could possibly lose a million jobs just in New York City alone. Which I can actually say it is 100% the government's fault that New York City may lose 900,000 jobs because of this lockdown. Yep, it is the government's fault 100%. Now, I know the other argument is like, well, would you rather have 900,000 people die? Not looking at the argument that way. I'm just saying they locked everyone down and they said, everyone put on plastic tarps, hide, don't come out of your house. And they officially destroyed an economy. And for as crazy as it sounds, we could actually still have a bull market, but yet the economy is in shambles. And it could remain in shambles just as long as Jerome continues to buy things that he is not legally allowed to do. But who is there to stop the Fed? Is it the president? I don't see that happening. Is it the people? No, they want their $1,200 checks. You can't live without your $1,200 checks. I mean, 99.999% of people have no idea how the Fed works, which I completely understand, because I know a lot of people with PhDs that actually do this for a living, and they don't even understand. It is so, money should not be complex, but when it comes to fraud, they can make it very complex so you don't know what they are doing, and that way they can prop up their lifestyle when you go work really hard and you fight for your NFL teams or your politicians because you think that, you know, your king's gonna save you, but he's not. The system is rigged, my friends. I figured that out a long time ago, and I'm just playing in a rigged system. I know, I get it. I'm like, this thing's immoral, corrupt, and wrong, but I'm not going to work a minimum wage job and die without experiencing life. You only got one life. And some of you have actually taken advantage of this 28% rally that has happened. And I know we plunged 34%, but then popped right back up 28%. And if I had a calculator, I would actually say that Google would get it wrong and probably tell me some weird thing, but not too much of a loss. And like I've said before on this channel, I don't fight the Fed. That's just part of the game, man. And I swing trade, and I know, you know, stocks go in channels, and stocks go up and they go down in channels. Look, do you see this? See this channel right here? I'll draw you a little terrible channel. And it goes up and it goes down and it goes up and it goes down and it goes up and it goes down. It goes, do you see? Do you see like a trend? The trend is your friend until the end. And then it breaks out of a channel, which you can see right here. And then you see what happens when it broke that channel. It goes up. Oh, now we have a new trend. And you just swing up, you swing down, you swing up, you swing down. I'll actually leave a code down below for 10% off. ZipTrader will actually teach you guys how to do this swing trading system, which there is a lot of different ways that you guys can play markets. You can play them with options. You can take out contracts and go, you know what, I'll go ahead and take ownership of that oil in a month from now. Let's just not worry about it until it shows up at your door. Because you're like, oh, wait, I actually have to take ownership of these 1,000 barrels of oil? Which that, looking at the calendar, that's coming up in about 2 weeks? We should be having another fluster cluck in oil. And what I'd like to do is point you in the direction of the last earnings call on February 11th. They'll do it after the market has closed. And then we had a huge gap down right there. And it looks to me like that started a whole new trend. Let me take a little peek and see what you would have lost on after that earnings call. The next day, oh yeah, you're down about 10%. So looking at this channel that we are currently in, sorry about my bad channel drawings, is this going to break to the upside? But really quick, before I leave this chart, RSI and MACD, this right there and that right there, looks like we have some momentum moving up on this. This is the 1 hour. So I'm looking at this on the 1 hour. These are actually oversold positions. So you might actually see Lyft move in the up. See, I say probabilities. You just throw everything into a can and go, you know what? It's an 80% chance. I'm just going to place my bet. And if I'm wrong, I put in a stop loss. And that way I don't lose so much of my money. And if you want to trade options and futures, that would be a very long course. As you guys know, I'm a high school business teacher. I just try to make this so simple for you. You take out your little Webull app. Link in the description on that one. I think they give you a free stock or Robinhood. I will not leave a link in the description. And you're just like, buy, sell, buy, sell. And you can actually buy stocks that move in the opposite direction. If you guys see this one, SPXL and SPXS, those are inverse correlations. So when the market goes up, one goes one way, and then you can buy the stock going down. That way you don't have to do put options and have to take ownership of 1,000 barrels of oil in the next 2 weeks. And then back to Bloomberg, New York City may lose 900,000. Just sounds so much better, you know, a million, just round it for a second. And who is going to be losing the most? Here is job losses by sector. And I also want to say that I do not mean to make light of the situation. It is not my fault. I am not the president. I did not put everyone on lockdown. And actually, I would never want to be president because I actually would like people to like me. I would wake up in the morning, I would see my approval rating at 30%. I'm like, Johnny Bravo, we gotta change this. So note to self, if you have anything in this area, you may want to reconsider your job and maybe start a side hustle, start a business, start selling things on Amazon. That way you don't have to get hit with this one right here. Food services, that just got wiped out. Retail, again, sell online and you won't be part of this red line. Healthcare, which is just weird because they need more healthcare workers. Actually here, they're furloughing people, which is so crazy. A boat shows up, no one even goes on the boat, no one's sick. The boat then goes away, not reported in the news. I think they treated like 20 people or something ridiculous. I don't know, I just don't know people's agendas. I don't get it. I don't know what's going on. I just go out, buy tinfoil, I make a nice little hat, and then I give you a big question mark and say, I don't know. The only thing that I do know is that I would just make a t-shirt with a big question mark on it and then sell it on Amazon or something like that. I will leave a link in the description below. I give you guys three codes available. They go pretty fast. Apologize for that. I give you two courses, normally valued at $1,300 for $197. That's it. Just one payment. That's why they go kind of fast. I teach you how to bring things like a t-shirt with a question mark that's like WTF. I have no idea. You know, I don't know what is going on. But heck, I will sell you a t-shirt and then I can stop working this job and that job. Or maybe I can cut back on that. Or, you know, the real estate I was doing isn't looking too good. But fortunately, my Amazon business is doing a lot better, but I can't guarantee that because if you pick a cruddy product, you're not going to sell it. And really quick, breaking news isn't everything. I need to get a breaking news banner that flashes. Breaking news, Uber cuts 3,700 jobs.
Hey, John, that's right. Uber is laying off 3,700 employees, and that accounts for about 14% of its total workforce. In a filing, the company says that that will likely result in $20 million in severance and benefit costs, but this wasn't unexpected, guys. Ride-sharing bookings, we know that they have fallen.
All right, so you know what? You guys that are doing the ride-sharing, I mean, it's definitely affected you, right? But looks like Uber's going to have to lay off some back office, which just usually happens in a recession. You got to cut the fat, get thinned out a little bit, and then you start getting a little bit more comfortable, you know? Then you're like, oh, kind of like with the quarantine, you're like, oh, these pants, did you like dry these two times over? Why are they so tight? Well, that's because you're eating too much, my friend. I would say lay off on the double stoof, okay? Especially the big ones. There's the mega. But I don't know, this is kind of tempting. $5.95. Oh, mother front door, look at this, you scammer. $15 for shipping. I bet you Skechers doesn't gouge you on that. And just to let you know, Skechers, we got Mother's Day. Make sure you buy your mom a pair of Skechers. And coming in from MarketWatch, you guys got to be careful. This might be a trap. This is the trap awaiting the stock market ahead of a grim summer. Warns a strategist because no one is going here. This rally could be a very big setup, which I don't care because I will be playing both sides of this. And just like always, the trend is your friend until the end, and it breaks the, I think this is the 50, I just drew over it, and the 200. I think it's Gunlocks thinks that we're probably gonna kind of just bounce in there. But I would say if you're playing the 50 week, moving average. Got to wait till it gets above that 50. Unfortunately, Market Watch went ahead and granted my wish. They left me a saying from Jeffrey. If the Fed does start buying ETFs, no. More illegal shenanigans from the Federal Reserve that's not even federal, nor do they reserve anything broadly and in size in response to recent requests. They do so as to not let down the buyers who front ran the Fed April 9th will not and should not be well received on Main Street. Well, Jeff, I don't think anyone on Main Street even cares, as they don't care. Well, they're like, oh, whatever. The rich people, they just keep getting richer, and I just lost my job, and life sucks basketballs, but I did get a check for $1,200, so I'll go out and buy myself a pair of Skechers. And last but not least, the stock market. This is May 6th. You see, I keep all of my news up to date, just breaking news. The stock market may get cut in half. Well, I'd like it to, but this, the most undervalued asset about to surge, billionaire investor says, can anyone guess what the most undervalued asset is? And if you said silver, you would be right, but not according to this article. Peter Schiff, the most undervalued asset. Ah, isn't that just beautiful? Pure fine gold. Do you guys have that? I have it. I do not trade the ETF. I do not trade gold. I just buy it for a rainy day. That's the only time. And this is money, kids. This is money, even though the contrast on the gold looks really bad. All right, sorry for the marketing there. So make sure that you guys own money. Do not own currency. Own money. Unless you want to use that currency to trade assets, then you are completely okay. But my take on gold, and I've said this a bazillion times, gold is not supposed to make you money because it is money. It's not supposed to be speculative because it's not speculative. It's just money. It's just sit there. It's really shiny. And if you're thinking about what should I get my mom on Mother's Day, let me show you. Get her this one right there. A nice bar of gold. And then she'll go, oh, that's so cute. Thank you so much. And then she'll put it in a closet or in a drawer. And because people have no idea the value of real money. Which reminds me, I got to get someone on this channel that can sell you their gold. I don't know, something about gold just makes me smile every time. So if you guys ever want to buy me a gift, you just head on out, send me a few of these gold bars. I will be happy as a lark or a clam. Or if you were to crossbreed a lark with a clam, you would get a lamb.